Conversation, but I just wanted to welcome all of you here. My name is Nick Palmer. I am the music director and conductor of the North Charleston Pops, and this is an event.
Woohoo!
Yeah, thanks, Jim. Our board members. We want to thank Jim Morris for letting us use his beautiful home for this one.
So thank you all for coming.
And I'm going to tell you a little bit about the performance in just a minute, but first I wanted to tell you a little bit about what we're doing with the Pops for the rest of the season. We are in the middle of our sixth season. We present 5 concerts a year. We just had a concert last night, and I know some of you went to the concert. We have 2 more concerts coming up. One is April 28th, and that's going to feature the music of Star Wars, sci-fi, and John Williams. So there's a lot of variety in that. In addition to Star Wars, you're going to be hearing things from The Hunger Games and Game of Thrones and all kinds of crazy stuff. So it's going to be really fun. We also will have a lot of Star Wars characters involved in the concert, so photo op right there. It's going to be a lot of fun. And then our final concert is on May 26th, and that's going to feature a group of 3 singers from New York. It's called Bravo Broadway, and they're going to be singing all kinds of Broadway hits from several different decades, including a lot of contemporary stuff. And they're all absolutely phenomenal performers. So I think that'll be another fun event as well. Part of what we do that's really what we feel almost more passionate about than actually doing concerts is helping kids in North Charleston. And we have several programs where we provide music education to kids and the experience of going to concerts. Last night we had several kids that were from Pepper Hill Elementary and the Northwoods Community Center. Which is great because a lot of these kids had never heard music, any kind of orchestral music before, so it's a great experience. We go before the concert, talk to them about it. We also run a pop string orchestra and chorus, and those are both going really, really well. So that's something that's really, really important to us. But we have an incredible concert this afternoon, which is going to be a blast. And for those of you who don't know a whole lot about Irish music like me, going to be a great learning experience for you to find out a little bit more about this really unique genre of music that's just so cool. We have an absolutely terrific two performers, that are going to be joining us, and I had the opportunity to get to know a little bit about Haley Richardson through Jim Morris, and I've heard a lot of recordings, but there's nothing like hearing somebody perform live, so that's going to be really exciting part of the afternoon. I'm going to read a little bit of the bio, and there's a lot of very complex Irish words in here that I may screw up, so just bear with me here. But Haley Richardson began making her mark in Irish music when she won the All-Ireland qualifier in the underage category at 6 years old. So that's pretty amazing right there. Over the past 9 years, she's amassed a long list of accomplishments and performed at venues all over the United States, Ireland, and the UK. She plays in a particular style. There are several styles. I just found this out because her mom, Donna, told me about this because I had no idea. But there are several different types of styles of Irish fiddling and Irish music in general. So the kind of style that she plays more than any other is the Sligo style. And she's been working under the tutelage of Brian Conway in New York City. And she was the 2015 Junior Fiddler of Dooney Award, and also 2013 she won the All-Ireland competition in both fiddle and fiddle slow airs, which is a little bit more like Irish songs and that kind of thing. She also won the Mid-Atlantic FLA champion, and I didn't know what FLA meant, and you spell it F-L-E-A-D-H, so I guess it's a Gaelic or Celtic word, but it means festival. But she won that, and she was featured in Fiddler's Magazine in fall 2015, and she did a recent debut album with her brother Dylan, which is really an awesome album. I've had an opportunity to hear the whole thing. It's called Heart on a String, and one of the things she's done recently, which I think is really, really cool, is she has produced a CD called Music for Mercy, and it's to benefit the Mercy Center in Bangkok, Thailand. And maybe she'll tell us a little bit more about that. She had several musicians under the age of 21 contribute songs for this CD, which benefits this organization that helps people out. And now, in addition to Haley performing on the fiddle tonight, we also have the guitarist Don Pensian, and he's been performing all over the place and was very gracious to come down to perform with us. He performs at the Martine de Kogan Project, John William. He's performed with Jill Chambliss, Captain Mackey, Goatskin and String Band, Legacy, and the new form band, The Pure Drop, which features Haley's teacher, Brian Conway. And it's interesting because he doesn't play with the traditional tuning of a guitar. So we have a lot of musicians in the room now. Normally the guitar is E, A, D, G, B, E. But the tuning he uses is D, A, D, G, A, D, which is completely different than what we normally do. And that's something that you use a lot of times when you're performing folk music. So we're thrilled to have them both here. He also performs on whistle, bow drum, and vocals. So let's welcome our two performers, Haley and Don.
Thank you. ones that I got from my teacher, Brian Conway, who's based in New York. And these are a couple of his favorite ones to play, so I'll play them now. And they're The Eclipse and The Sunshine.
Thank you. speak, but I'm going to go ahead. I've been performing Irish music with world-class musicians for a very long time. I've been in the Irish music world for 30 years now. And as was kindly mentioned by Nick at the beginning of the show, Haley is an All-Ireland champion. She is the reigning champion in All-Ireland in the slow airs. Is it any wonder when you hear that performance? To be able to play an air well is actually an extraordinarily challenging thing to do, because you not only have to have great technical proficiency, but you got to have heart. And Haley has ample quantity as well.
Should I play jig?
Sounds good.
All right. So we'll do a little medley of tunes now. The first one is one that was composed by a wonderful fiddle player named Tommy Peoples, and it's called Don't Touch That Green Linnet. And we'll follow that with a tune that I wrote for a friend of mine, actually. I was doing some shows in Boston this past December for a Christmas show tour, and one of the harp players, Maine Gilchrist, wonderfully talented girl, we would be sharing a dressing room, and I'd be doing my makeup before the shows, and she saw that I was doing this thing with my eyeliner. She's like, "What is that?" And I'm like, "Oh, it's called a cat eye." And she's like, "Can you do that for me?" So I had already composed this tune, and I did not have a name for it yet, and I was desperately searching for a name. And she said, "You know, you could name it after me." And so I did, and the name of the tune is called Maeve's Cat Eye. And we'll follow that with a traditional tune called The Yellow Taker.
Thank you.
happen is that the name of the tune comes before the actual tune comes. But there's this place that we love to go in July. It's called Swannanoa Gathering, and it's a camp in Asheville, North Carolina. And it's on the Warren Wilson College campus. And not only do they have Celtic Week, but they also have Song Week, they have Fiddle Week. So basically, if you're a music junkie, that's where you'll find some of the best teachers and tunes being played, and it's just tons of fun. So we'd love to go there every year. I've been, I think, for the past 8 or 9 years. And something that they always announce at the beginning of the week is the bear sightings on campus. And, you know, just to be safe, I only know a couple people who have seen the bear. And, you know, just to be safe, they want to announce that you should be looking out for it. You know, when you're walking back to your hotel room at 4 a.m. after playing some good music, you want to be careful. So I'm always absolutely terrified that I'm going to encounter this bear. And there are several dorms on the college campus that you can be placed in. And a few of them are over across this bridge. And you have to go through a little pathway in the woods to get to them. So, of course, Mom and I always get put in the dorm that's across the bridge that you have to go through the woods to get to. So we're walking back, and it happens every night. We walk back, and we're going across this bridge, and we're jingling our name tags like bear bells, and just hoping and praying. And we get to this stretch of the pathway in the woods, and it's about 100 feet long, and it's just, we dart back to our room. It's absolutely terrifying. So we like to call that little stretch 100 feet of terror. So I thought, you know, what a great tune name that would be. So then came 100 feet of terror. So hope you like it.
Thank you.
with a little waltz that was written by a great friend of ours named Billy McComiskey, who's based in Baltimore, and he's one of the best accordion players, and actually just won the National Heritage Award, I think maybe a year or two ago, and very proud that he's an Irish musician. And he wrote a wonderful tune called The Diamond Waltz, so we'll play that one next, and then we'll follow that with a reel that I have no idea what the name of it is, so we just call it the question mark reel. And the one after that is called The Girl Who Broke My Heart, and we'll follow that with a traditional Shetland tune called Up De Strudes. So can you get that?
Thank you. I don't know the name of?
Yes.
John Doherty's.
Thank you so much.
It is an A, right?
Yes. Perfect.
No, I've definitely heard it before, yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I knew it at one point, and then I forgot. But now it's good.
Now I have it.
So, we'll play a couple more jigs. These are the ones by Eileen O'Brien, who I mentioned earlier. And they're two of her own compositions. They're called The Fly in the Porter and The Burning Bricks. From all around the States, all around Ireland, a couple from Canada as well, And we all came together to raise money for the Mercy Center. Like I said, it's an orphanage in Thailand, but they also run several, I think it's upwards of 22 kindergartens in the slum areas of Bangkok, where kids have the opportunity to learn that they otherwise would not have. And I actually had the chance to go over to Thailand and visit all of these kids in June. And I was expecting to walk into a totally different situation than I did. I was expecting it to be, you know, kind of sad, like you would normally think an orphanage would be, but it was the exact opposite, and all of these kids were super cheerful and just totally respectful, and it was really a joy to meet them all and know where the money's going. So 100% of the proceeds from the Music for Mercy CD go to those kids, so it's a great cause. And if you're interested in taking our music home with us, feel free to do so. So once again, thank you all so much for coming. Thanks to Tacy for setting this up, and thanks to Jim for letting us use his house and setting this up as well. It's really been a joy to play for you all. So we'll finish off with first a Scottish piece called Sweetness of Mary, and then we'll follow that with a tune called The Mason's Apron that's played by multiple different fiddling traditions. I know some bluegrass players and some Scottish players who play this one, as well as Irish musicians. And the version that I got, there's bunches of different versions, but the one that I got is from a fiddle player by the name of Sean McGuire, and he was notorious for taking basic tunes and just making them totally fancy. And he was really, really famous for his show pieces, so this is one of them. And I hope you enjoy it. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
really, that was just amazing.
Thanks so much.
It was so cool. We loved every minute of it. So hopefully you get an opportunity to talk to both of our wonderful performers during dinner. And I just wanted to say that the dinner is provided by Jim and Nick's Barbecue, which has done a lot for the Pops. And so, yeah, we're really thrilled to have them providing the meal. They work with us on our children's program, especially our summer camp. So fill your plate, find a place to sit and mingle. And thanks for coming.